Shiva Arunachala, Arunachala Shiva Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva Arunachala. Ipparita punai yeni nai pita, ini yar viduva Arunachala. Ilu mannai devi darul puri ho, idu darul Arunachala. Unaiye maatri oda dullathin mel urudiyayirupa Arunachala. Usurthullam vilandu naikkandadangira unnalagai kaattarunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Yenai azhithu podu yenai kalavaavidu idho aanmai Arunachala. Yen indha urakkam yenai piraridukka idho unakkalago Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Aimbula kalva agathinil purumbol agathinil ilayo Arunachala. Oruvanam unnai olithavar varuva unsuge idu Arunachala. Omkara porul oppuyarvillo unaiyar arivar Arunachala. Avvai mole nakku unnarulai thandindrai aaluvadun kadan Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala.
Arunachalam vaazhi anbargalum vaazhi aksharamanamalai vaazhi. Paranarndidu guhayandu Harivam Viritiravai Nisamarivai Adhuveriyam Annamalayai Adiyenai Andanre Aviyudal Kondayanakkor Kurayundo Kurayum Gunamum Niyallal Enne Nivatrai Ennuire Ennam Yeduvo Adu Seivai Kanne Undan Kalalinayir Kadar Perukke Tharuvaye Kanne Undan Kalalinayir Kadar Perukke Tharuvaye Shri Arunachalam, Shri Arunachalam, Shri Arunachalam. So first today we started with a Krishna way of life. And yesterday we saw what is the secret of meditation. I was wondering whether people would be turning up today. After yesterday's bouncers. See, for the advanced seeker, it would have made real sense. But for the beginners or for the devotees who are starting, it would have been real difficult thing to accept or digest. So today is Somavar, Monday, and it's very, very auspicious for Shiva. So Arunachala is nothing but Shiva himself. So therefore we thought today we would take the glories of Arunachala. And tomorrow the sage of Arunachala. And our host, Sri Surendranji, is a great bhakta of Arunachala and even Amma. So they were sort of requesting me to take more of Arunachala and Bhagavan. So we even changed the topics and we sent the second circular round. See, though I was associated with Thiruvannamalai for a long time, I was going again and again. I was initially attracted by Bhagavan only, Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharishi. And he was pulling me again and again to Thiruvannamalai. I used to go to Sri Ramanashram and go up in the hills, and there are caves and all. So we used to meditate and all. And we were reading Bhagavan and trying to understand, trying to assimilate. But at those times, we were not very serious about Arunachala. We were thinking, yes. See, sometimes, you know, as a young person, we think these Puranas are too much. They exaggerate things. Like sort of a James Bond movie. Like that, they exaggerate things. So we don't take it that serious. That was my attitude at that point of time. Means after studying scriptures, after teaching Vedanta also, I was having this sort of an idea. So not taking Arunachala seriously. Okay, good. So used to go around the hill, not as a this thing of devotion, but just out of curiosity, just to explore. You know, but after surrendering to Arunachala, I used to visit Ramanashram for Parayanam in the evenings. And there they chant Vistuti Panchakam, Mondays. And then I got interested. And then when I started reading the glories of Arunachala in Bhagavan's own words. See, Bhagavan is a person who never sort of, you know, exaggerates or, you know, go ha-ha, gaga over things. He was always quiet. But if that person is talking something about Arunachala, it must be true. That was my sort of thinking. So then, when you read Arunachala Stuti Panchakam, Bhagavan's work about Arunachala, then you fall in love with Arunachala. Once when you fall in love with Arunachala, when you approach with a lot of devotion, and when you start worshipping him, then you will understand what is Arunachala. See, I have not fully understood, truly speaking, I have not understood Arunachala. It's only with the faith that my Guru or Bhagavan has said, so it must be true. That's how we approach. But when you approach with faith, with all love and devotion, Arunachala reveals slowly his glories. So whatever I understood about Arunachala, I want to share with you all. See, Bhagavan, he says, Karunar Navamai Karudakkadi Nalhum Arunachala Shivamidam. In these two lines, he gives the essence of what is Arunachala. He starts like this, Karunar Navamai. Arnava means ocean. Karunar Navamai. He is ocean of compassion. See, even the chanting of Suti Panyam starts with this verse. It's Bhagavan's own verse. He is ocean of compassion. Today morning also we saw Arul Niraivana Amudak Kadale. Arul Niraivana Amudak Kadal. What a wonderful thing. See, only when you really know Tamil, you can really enjoy this. Karunar Navamai. He is ocean of compassion. Karudak Kadinalhum. And what is his glory? Karudak Kadinalhum. Karuda means when you think about him. Kadinalhum. He gives you moksha. He liberates you. What sort? Is it possible? When you just think about him, he liberates you. I was always wondering, this is little exaggeration. That's not true. Is that not true? But Bhagavan emphasizes this point in Padigam also. He says, Karudiye tirivir, karuttinul oruhal, karudida kolamale kollum, arumarundonrundu, arumarundu onru undu, avaniyil adudan, aruna, arunama tiramena arivir. He says, oh, mankind, you are roaming here and there. Karuttinul oruhal karudida. You think about Arunachala even once. Karuttinul, in your mind. When you think about even once. Kolamale kollum aru marundu ondru undu. It kills you. Oh, this is the aru marundu, this is the medicine which will kill you. Kill you means what? It will destroy your jiva bodha, the ahankara bhavana, the ego sense. That is what killing. Kolamale kollum. That's why he said kolamale kollum. Or aru marundu. Real medicine is there in this world. Where is it? Arunama tiramena arivir. This is Arunachala, he says. See, when a person who is always reveling in the truth, immersed, drowned in truth, when he says a word, it has got a great meaning. So therefore Bhagavan says, if you think about him, you are liberated. It is very famously said, Smaranat Arunachala. Means in our tradition it is said, when you are, born in Tiruvarur, then you are liberated. And our ex-chief minister also was born there.
Yes.
And when you have darshan of Chidambaram, you are liberated. That's most wonderful. And when you go and die in Kashi, you are liberated. So people go all the way to Kashi to die. But you know, when they fall ill, their sons come all the way, they fly and come and they take them to Delhi for treatment. Adukku or kodupinu venum. in Delhi, when you die in Kashi, you are liberated. But Arunachala, when you just think about it, Nekka Mukti, when you think about it, you are liberated. But Swamiji, I have been thinking about Arunachala always, but onnu nadakka kaanume.
That's what I think.
Yeah, I am my miserable self. Why nothing is happening? How do you know nothing is happening? He is working inside. See, certain things like the blossoming of the flower, you cannot see. Hey, beautifully it blossoms, even before you realize it. So similarly, this ahattamarai, the malaradu namak theriyadu. So it is working. Therefore, with faith, we have to really think about it. Arunachala smaranam. That is very auspicious. Karunar navamai karudak kadinalhum Arunachala shivam idam. Bhagavan says, this Arunachala, this mountain is Shiva himself, he says. Again and again he says, even places like Kailash, it's only Arunachala's or Shiva's vasasthalam, his abode, where he and Parvati, they reside there. You must have gone to Kailash. Have you seen Shiva and Parvati residing there? No?
Yes.
Yes, sir, ma'am.
Yes.
Imagine.
Yes. Rana, there's a story, King Without a Cloth. King without clothes in the old story. Right?
The Emperor's new clothes.
Emperor without clothes.
No, the Emperor's new clothes.
Emperor new clothes. If you are not seen, you don't have faith. But Arunachala is Shiva himself. Arunachala is Shiva himself. Why? The Purana says, the Lord Shiva appeared as an infinite column of light to teach this Brahma and Vishnu a lesson. That infinite column of light, Adimudi illa the Jodhya Thodunar. At that time, Brahma and Vishnu, they tried to fathom his head or his feet, but they couldn't. So, after that, they accepted their defeat and they bowed down. And all the other Rishi Munis, they also came there and they requested Lord Shiva, it's very difficult to approach you. You are fire. How can we approach you? Anna Malai. Anna means what? It's difficult to approach. Anna. Anna Malai. So therefore, we have to take a Saumya Rupa so that we can worship you. So that column of light, out of compassion to bless the devotees, that became the hill. That is Arunachala. So Bhagavan says, other places are abodes of Shiva, but this is Shiva himself in physical form. If you go and touch, you are touching Shiva himself. See, Bhagavan, he emphasizes this point. This is Shiva himself. That is why it is really powerful. Shiva himself there. It is said in Satya Yuga, it was emerald Maragadamalai. And the next Yuga, it was Ponmalai. It was gold. And then this third Yuga, it was silver. And now God knows. Kali Yuga, these fellows will sell me out. So he became a sort of a rocky hill. Kalmalayaitar. So he is Shiva.
Name Pavalakundru.
That is Pavalakundru close by. Yeah. He himself is Shiva only. See, that is why in Mahatmyam. See, Mahatmyam is, you know what? Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, he was going through Puranams. In Skanda Puranam, I suppose, he saw the glories of Arunachala brought out in Sanskrit verses as Nandivak. Then he culled out important verses and then he made it into Tamil and then he gave it as Arunachala Mahatmya, that is chanted in Ramanashrama, in the Parayana. There it is said beautifully. I tell you, this is the most beautiful verse. I love it. You repeat after me? Will you repeat after me? Aduvetalam.
Aduvetalam.
Arunachalam.
Arunachalam.
Talam yavilum adiham.
Talam yavilum adiham.
Adu bhoomiyin idayam.
Adu bhoomiyin idayam.
Hari. Aduve sivan.
பதியாமுரு
மறுமத்தலம்
மறுமத்தலம்
பதியாமவன் அதிலே
பதிவான்
ஒளிமலையா
ஒளிமலையா
நிதம் அருணாச்சலமெனவே. Bhagavan says, or the Skanda Puranam says, as Nandi Vak it has come out, Aduve Talam, that is the real Talam. Stalam means that is the Stalam. Aduve Talam. Arunachalam. You know what is the meaning of Arunachalam? See, Arunachalam means, Runam means Bandham. Runam. Runam. A Runam means what? When you think about it, all your bandha, all your bondage gone. That is Arunachalam. Achalam means which is changeless or which should not move. That is the mountain or the Atma, the self. Whatever you want, you can take.
Where am I telling? Arunam na light. In the morning, Suryan pair Arunam.
Adu so correct. That light. Adu yeah. Is the light of consciousness. Adu no meaning. Correct. So, light of consciousness which is changeless. Achalam. Arunachalam. Aduve talam arunachalam. Talam yavidum adiham. Meaning, if you compare with all the other stala, the glory of Arunachala, you can never compare. Incomparable. Talam yavidum adiham. Adu bhoomi in idayam. He says that is the heart of this bhoomi. Of this earth. See, Bhagavan, he mentions that this is the center of the universe or center of the earth, he says. But actually, the philosophical meaning, the Arunachala is Atma, the self only. And Bhumi in Idaya means what? It is the center of everything, because from here arises everything. And subsides. Everything subsides here. Adu bhoomi in idayam. Hari, aduve sivan idayap padiyam. If at all there is a padi or there is a stalam which is very close to Shiva's heart, it is Thiruvannamalai only. See, we say, na, I have so many houses everywhere. But the house in Melbourne is very close to my heart. You say, na? So, Shiva also says, Sivan idayapadiya, this padi or this sthalam is very close to Shiva's heart because Shiva himself is there. Idayapadiya, oru marumattalam. Bhagavan says, idu oru marumattalam. It's a mysterious place. Marumattalam, it's true, it is marumattalam. What is marumam about this place? I tell you from my own experience. The marumam is not that siddhas are flying. People ask me, Swami, have you seen siddhas flying? Why birds are also flying? Why should a siddha fly and prove that he is a siddha? No, Swamiji, in the video I saw, just light going. You don't know, maybe. Or maybe some sort of a graphics. We don't know. But we are very excited or curious about extraordinary things. But you know what is the marumam? The extraordinary thing of Arunachala is when you go and sit quietly, you will find your mind just melting effortlessly. That is marmam there. We don't know why. I tell you, with all Shraddha and Bhakti, if you come to Arunachala, you need not do anything there. Please understand. Yes, Girivalam is sort of advised. You can go. But the very important thing is Ninaikka Mukti. Just look at him and just drink his glorious form. Or sit quietly. That is enough. I tell you, you will find your mind just to melt. Especially I have seen during Pradosha time and all. In Arunachala, I tell you, when you sit for meditation, effortlessly you just glide into your own self. Like this, it's gone. That is Marumattala. You know why it is Marumattalam? Bhagavan himself has said in the sixth verse of Mahatmyam, he says, Yosanai Moonram Ittala Vasarku Asaru Thikai Adi Indriyum Yen Pasamil Sayuchiyam Payakkumme Isanam Yendan Anayinale. Shiva himself has said, Yosanai Moonram Ittala Vasarku. That is a sort of a distance given in a circumference of moon Yosanai. Three yojana means 30 kilometers, they say. 30 kilometers around Arunachala. Yosanai Moonra Ittala Vasarku. One who are residing in Arunachala and practicing austerities. Asaru Thikai Adi Indriyum. Asaru means what? That which destroys the sins. Thikai means initiation. Guru Upadesha. Thikai Indri. Without even Guru's initiation, or without even sort of struggling too much, Pasamil Sayuchyam Payakkumme, you will attain the Sayujya, the state of Sayujya, or the state of liberation. Why? Isanam Yendan Anayinale. It is my order. Shiva says, Isanam Yendan Anayinale. This is my order. Those who live distance of 30 kilometers around Arunachala, for them there is no need for any diksha, and they would not struggle in meditation or in the sadhana, and without any effort they get that the mukti or liberation. Why? It is my order, full stop. You cannot appeal against Supreme Court's order, na? And Supreme Court has given a judgment, it is a final. Similarly, if Shiva, he says, Isanam Yendan Anayinale. See, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi quotes this often. See, once there was a bhakta, a devotee came from Sringeri. He had great reverence and devotion for Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. But he was little cranky, like some devotees. He thought, Bhagavan should take formally sannyasa. If you don't take sannyasa formally, then you will not get it. That's what his idea. So he came to Bhagavan with his baggage and everything. He climbed up, he was in the hill. So he told Bhagavan, Bhagavan, I appreciate you are a great person, a jnani and all. But still, you have to take sannyasa. So I have brought all the clothes, the ochre robes and other things. You have to take sannyasa. Then only you will attain the final thing. Something like that he was saying. Bhagavan was very quiet. He was very young at that time. He didn't say anything. Just remaining quiet. He was not having any urge to do anything. Then he said, okay Bhagavan, I will go and take bath and come back. You please desire and tell me. And then he left the place, leaving his luggage. Then Bhagavan, for no reason, he picked up, there was a book in his part of his luggage, he picked up, and that was this verse. And then we returned back, he showed this. He said, see, so there is no need for initiation or for formal sort of sannyasa or anything here. Without anything, you attain that, sayuchyam. Why? Isanam in the Nanayinale. So therefore, you know why it is Marumattalam? Here effortlessly mind glides into Atma itself. That is why I tell devotees, whenever you come to Arunachala, you come there, Ardala Varanu. You know, you should not plan to visit 50 temples in 5 days. People come like that, you know. They come from the foreign countries. They have only 1 week's time. And they have in their itinerary, you know, Chidambaram ponum, Thiruvannamalai ponum, appadiye flight eduthu Varanasi poyittu vandranum, appra Kanchipuram ponum, inga ponum, inga ponum. Why? They want to go back and boast. Na engellam ponen theriyuma? I went here, went there, went there, went there. My God, everywhere the same Parameshwara is there. And he is in your heart also. See, Yoga Swami says, he went to Kashi. Sri Yoga Swami, the saint of Jaffna. He says, Kashikku vandu kandeyan kadavulai en kavattaikkul. He said. Meaning what he is in. So, you know, we are very, very childish. See, we want to see this. So we run. And there is no shanti. So what do you gain out of it? Nothing. And you go on complaining. Ella utayarku, this is not good, that is not good, priests are useless, they are charging money, they are greedy, this, that. Why have you gone there? To disturb yourself like this? You take one place, whichever is very close to your heart. Varanasi means Varanasi. Chidambaram means Chidambaram. Go one place, sit there for 2-3 days, worship Bhagavan. And meditate and take all the blessings and then come back. Or at least 2 places, 3 places you choose. People come, you know, para, they come. Swamiji, I have got 2 days, I have to finish this, I have to go for Girivalam, I have to do this, do that. The pakatla on the Tirukovil Rukame, Anga Ulahalan the Perumal Rukare, however you already path to underno, the pakatla Korkovil Rukame Velula, Adim path to underno. Why all this? So if you want really to take the blessings of Arunachala, you should come there and sit quietly for some time. That is why Ramanashram is there, that is why the caves are there, that is why some other ashrams are there. Come and sit quietly. So when you sit quietly, I tell you, the mind will melt by itself and it will return to its own source without any effort. There is some sort of power there. Marumattalam. That's why Bhagavan says Marumattalam. Padiyam avanadile vadivan oli malaya nidam Arunachalam enave. Padiyam avan. Padi means the Lord. Shiva. Vadivan. He resides there. How? Oli malaya. Like effulgent mountain. Oli malaya nidam Arunachalam enave. Therefore, that is the most wonderful place. And there lived a great, great jnani called Guhai Namachivaya. He says, Jnanathabodhanarai vayanru alaikkum malai Annamalai. He says, Annamalai, what it does? Jnanathabodhanarai, those who seek knowledge, the real knowledge, he invites as if, come. So once when you come to Thiruvannamalai, I tell you, it will pull you again and again. See, not devotees or bhaktas, even the IT fellows, the young fellows, they come to me and say, Swamiji, I just came to Thiruvannamalai once, but I don't know why. Whenever I feel like a little stressed or a little, you know, down, I want to come here again. I don't know why. They say, because that is the glory of Arunachala. It pulls you again and again. And what Arunachala does to a sadhaka, to a seeker, Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi has given a beautiful picture, a beautiful sort of description of what Arunachala will do to you. When you come to Arunachala, what it will do to you. There is one padikam. No, Bhagavan has written Arunachala padikam. See, it starts with Karunaya. See, a very, very interesting story. Bhagavan never used to think about anything. You sit quietly. it has so happened, this word just cropped up. It just came into his consciousness, Karunayal. Bhagavan was ignoring it. What is this? He ignored everything. But again and again it was coming up. So it was said, he just poured out this padikamu. One verse per day, it just came out. And that is how this padikam came, its spontaneous outpour. It just came out. There, the 10th one says, what Arunachala does to a devotee. I will read. I would expect you to repeat also. I tell you. பார்த்தனன் புதுமை உயிர்வலி காந்த பருவதம் ஒருதரம் இதனை மூர்த்திடும்
உயிரின்
சேட்டையை ஒடுக்கி
ஒருதன
தபிமுகமாக ஈர்த்ததை தன் போல் அச்சலமா செய்து அவ்வின்னுயிர் பலிகொடும் இருது என்னுயிர் பலிகொடும் இருது என் ஓர் துய்மின்னுயிர்காள் உளமதில் ஒளிரில் உயிர்கொலி அருணமாகிரியே. பூச்சிக்கொல்லி, பெஸ்டிசைட், பூச்சிக்கொல்லி, திஸ் இஸ் உயிர்கொல்லி. உயிர்கொலி மீன்ஸ் வாட்? இட் கில்ஸ் யூ. இட் கில்ஸ் உயிர்கள் மீன்ஸ் வர் த ஜீவாஸ். உயிர்கொலி. சோ வாட் இட் டஸ்? பார்த்தனன் புதுமை. மை காட், ஐ ஹவ் நெவர் சீன் சச் திங் பிஃபோர். சோ வண்டர்ஃபுல் திங். பார்த்தனன் புதுமை. பகவான் ஹிம்செல்ஃப் யூ நோ எக்ஸ்கிளைம்ஸ் லைக் திஸ். பார்த்தனன் புதுமை. உயிர் பலி காந்த பருவதம். உயிர்கள் மீன்ஸ் ஜீவாஸ். பலி, பலிந்து மீன்ஸ் ஃபோர்ஸ்ஃபுல்லி. உயிர் வலி காந்த பருவதம், லைக் மேக்னட், இட் புல்ஸ் த ஜீவா ஃபோர்ஸ்ஃபுல்லி. தட் இஸ் த க்ளோரி ஆஃப் திஸ் பருவதம், திஸ் ஹில். ஒரு தரம் இதனை ஓர்த்திடும் உயிரின். அண்ட் ஒன்ஸ் இஃப் யூ ரியலி சின்சியர்லி திங்க் அபவுட் திஸ் பருவதம், திஸ் ஓர்த்திடு மீன்ஸ் இஃப் யூ மெடிடேட் அபவுட் திஸ் அருணாச்சலா ஈவன் ஒன்ஸ், வாட் இட் டஸ்? உயிரின் சேட்டையை ஒடுக்கி. சேட்டை மீன்ஸ் யூ நோ வாட்? சேட்டை பண்ணாதா? நம்ம எப்போ சேட்டை பண்ணிட்டே இருக்கோம். சேஷ்டை, அங்கே போகிறது, இங்கே போகிறது, அதை செய்யுது, இதை செய்யுறது, அது வேணும், இது வேணும். திஸ் ஜீவபாவா, த சேஷ்டை மீன்ஸ் வாட்? இட் வாண்ட்ஸ் திஸ், தேட், அண்ட் இட் மெசஸ் அப் எவ்ரி திங். திஸ் இஸ் ஜீவபோதாஸ், ஜீவா சேஷ்டை. சேட்டையை ஒடுக்கி. When you go to Arunachala, when you meditate, when you think about him, all your vasanas will be burnt. So therefore, chumma cheta pannit irukka maatinga. Enna seivinga? Orudana abhimugamaga eerthu. This is very important. The mind is always extroverted, always reveling or going into the world. But Arunachala, what he does, the jeeva sheshtakal ellam odukki, ஈர்த்து, ஒரு தர அபிமுகமாக ஈர்த்து. மீனிங் வாட்? ஹி புல்ஸ் யூ விதின். மீனிங் வாட்? த மைண்ட் விச் இஸ் பகிர்முகா வில் பிகம் அந்தர்முகா. நாட் பை யுவர் எஃபர்ட், பை ஹிஸ் கிரேஸ். சோ ஹி, வென் யூ திங்க் அபவுட் ஹிம், ஹி இஸ் இன் த ஹார்ட், ஹி வில் புல் யூ. அண்ட் தன் போல் அச்சலமா செய்து. Achala means what? He is not moving, na? So he will make your mind also still, not moving. Achalama seidu innuir baligolum. Innuir means this innuir, this jeeva bhavana baligolum. Bali means what? It kills, it destroys the jeeva bhava. So when you think about Arunachala, he is Virvali Kanda Parvadam. He just attracts you, pulls you forcefully. And then whatever, maybe because of your vasana, whatever cheshtangal you are doing, all those will be quieted. And then you become introvert. Ahamuha mahi, antarmuha ahi. And it will make your mind still. When your mind is still, the ahankara is destroyed. That's why it is called as virkoli. Idu yen, what is this? I have never seen such a thing before. What is this? Even if you think once about this, it will kill you. Therefore, orthu uyir min uyirhaal, uyirhaal. Out of, you know, love, he says, orthu uyimin uyirhaal, uyimin. Pulachu ponga ninga ellarum. Uyimin, uyirhaal, ulamadil olir. Iv uyirkoli arunamagiri. He says, ulamadil olir. Arunamagiri is outside, in the world outside, but he says, ulamadil olir. It is actually inside. Ulamadil olir. It is in your heart shining as I. So, even if you think or meditate on this Arunachala Tattvam, even once, you need not do anything. He will do everything for you. We have to approach with all love and devotion. With a faith in the words of the Master. See, if somebody has said, I would not have taken it seriously. But Bhagavan himself has said, Ramana Maharshi has said. So he has said, this Arunach Parthanan Pudumai, I have never seen such thing. So when you come there and sit quietly and meditate, you will find, that is Marumattalam. You will find your mind by itself becoming quiet, still. And then this confusion about ourselves, it goes. Chichada granti alla arundu poi. Only chit matrama you will remain. When you remain as chit matram in chidakasham, there is nothing other than you. There is nothing other than you. You alone. I alone am. So this is the experience. So this will happen. I tell you, this is not a rocket science. This is a very simple thing. When you give attention to yourself, that's it. The real self manifests. The false self perishes. That's it. And then, everything is known to you. Only because we identify with the body, we see a world outside other than ourselves. When this body identification goes, there is nothing called as outside or inside. There is no nama rupa, you know, bhinna bhinna, different. There is no chit jada, beda. There is nothing. There is only that I, that conscious principle. This will be ullamkai nellikkanibol, it will be very obvious, very clear. So therefore, this Arunachala is most wonderful. So in every stelam, there is some speciality, some special sadhanas are sort of mentioned. If you go to Kashi, there you have to do japa. Because when you do japa in Kashi, when you do once, it will be 1,000 times beneficial. Likewise, in different stalam, there are different sadhanas prescribed. In Arunachala, very special sadhana is prescribed, that is Giri Pradakshina. Bhagavan has emphasized and he himself has shown the path. Giri Pradakshina is very important. When you go to Arunachala, you have to go around the hill, keeping Arunachala to your right. Pradakshina means what? Keeping right. You have to go around the hill. I tell you, early morning is a wonderful time. Or in the evening. You should not go with a company. You should go alone. And remember Arunachala. and that's it. And Bhagavan, what he says, you know, you should walk very slowly, gracefully, like a pregnant lady. Not just a pregnant lady, a princess who became pregnant, how she walks. Princess, ஒரு இளவரசி நடக்கிறதா எப்படி நடப்பா? ஒய்யாரமா அண்ணம் போல் நடையெல்லாம் சொல்லுவோம் இல்லையா? அவள் மெதுவாக தான் நடப்பா. அவளுக்கு ஒன்றும் பரபரப்பு இல்லை. அவளுக்கு எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் டன் ஃபார் ஹர். அவளே இஃப் ஷீ இஸ் ப்ரெக்னென்ட் ஹவு ஷீ வாக்ஸ், அந்த மாதிரி வி ஹவ் டு வாக்னு பகவான் சொல்கிறார். வி ஹவ் டு வாக் ஸ்லோலி. பட் யூ நோ வாட் ஐ சி பீப்புள், தே சே யூ நோ ஐ ஹவ் ஃபினிஷ் திஸ் இன் 2.5 hours. இன் 2 hours மீன்ஸ் லிட்ரலி தே ரன். And most of the time they are on the phone also. The real time to avoid Giri Pradakshinam is Paurnami. I can tell you, God, they have destroyed Arunachala. So it becomes so commercial, lot of, you know, shops, people here, there, and you don't have any peace there. But அதையும் ஏற்றுக்க முடிஞ்சால் அதுவும் நல்ல விஷயந்தான். பட் ஏகாந்தமாக இந்த மார்னிங் ஆர் இந்த ஈவினிங் யூ ஹேவ் டு கோ வாக் ஸ்லோலி, திங்க் அபவுட் அருணாச்சலா அண்ட் கோ அரவுண்ட் த ஹில். தட் இஸ் வெரி பெனிஃபிஷியல். ஐ டெல் யூ, வெரி பெனிஃபிஷியல். முருகனார் சுவாமிகள், அத்தியந்த டிவோட்டி ஆஃப் பகவான் ரமண மகர்ஷி, ஹீ கேம் டு பகவான் அண்ட் ஹி வாஸ் ஆஸ்கிங், மீன்ஸ் இனிஷியல் ஸ்டேஜஸ் ஹி வாஸ் ஆஸ்கிங் பகவான், பகவான் வாட் இஸ் so great about Arunachala Giri Pradakshinam. See, Muruganar Swamigal was a very young person at that time. Just then he had come to Bhagavan, and few months or maybe few weeks, I don't know, he asked Bhagavan and said, what is so great about Arunachala Giri Pradakshinam? Then Bhagavan said, don't ask me anything, you first go on a pradakshinam, you will see. But Muruganar Swamigal, again he asked it, Bhagavan said, you first go, don't ask me anything, you go. Muruganar Swamigal was so matured and ripe, even when he came to Bhagavan, that he was walking around the hill and he says, Muruganar Swamigal says, when he was crossing that Adi Annamalai, he lost his body consciousness. And he says, I lost my body consciousness. He was walking around the hill, but he could not feel his body. He came back bewildered. Oh, what is this? Then Bhagavan smiled, asked, Purunjitha unakku? That is it, he said, it seems. So, Pakkuvigalukku, the Arunachalam irukke, periya oru pokkisham, jnana pokkisham. So, therefore, going around the hill is very important. And there is a wonderful temple. But, you know what? In temple, there is Arunachalar, Arunachaleshwarar. That is only a symbol, lingam. Linga Rupam. But the real thing is there as a mountain. 24/7 open. Nadai thaathradhum kedaadhu, tharakradhum kedaadhu. When you go to the temple, people, devotees may sort of hide, sort of ellathaiyum maraippaanga illaya. Ayyar ellam peruman perumana irupaanga, ellarum poi marachiruvaanga. You can't see Arunachala, but here you can see from anywhere. He is always available. So, see, இதுதான் நம்மளோட அறிவீனம். பகவான் சார், ஹி சாக்ஷாத் சிவபெருமான் ஸ்டாண்டிங் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் யூ. பட் ஐ வாண்ட் டு கோ இன் தட் க்ரௌட், ஐ வாண்ட் டு முங்கி அடிச்சு அந்த அவரையுமே பார்த்துடணும். பார்க்க வேண்டாம் சொல்ல, எனக்கு பெரிய பாவம் வந்துடும் போது பார்க்க வேண்டான்னு சொல்லலை. பார்க்கணும், இங்கே இருக்காரு அவர். இதுதான் நமக்கு, வி ஆர் ரெஸ்ட்லெஸ் பை நேச்சர். ஸோ இன் வென் யூ கம் டு திருவண்ணாமலை, சிவன் இஸ் தேர் அட் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் ஹில். பகவான் சார் அகெயின் அண்ட் அகெயின். So Bhagavan, only once he had visited temple, it seems. First time when he came, he went into the temple and he hugged Arunachala. That's what they say. There was nobody, it seems. Afterwards, he meditated in the Palalinga and all. He never visited temple, it seems. Meaning what? When you know this is Arunachala and Arunachala is in the heart. And what is, where is the question of, you know, going into the crowd and, you know, hitting each other and want to have darshan. So therefore, Girivalam is very important, Arunachala is very important. That is a story, very wonderful story. Once what happened, Lord Shiva and Parvati they were enjoying themselves in the Kailash. At one playful moment, Parvati thought, I want to play with Shiva. So she just went behind Shiva and she closed his eyes, it seems. With her hand, she closed his eyes. Shiva didn't expect this. And that is a serious thing. Because when you close the eyes of Shiva, the Parameshwara, it is said the whole world will sort of lose its balance. So, they were running helter-skelter because everything was shaking. Everything was sort of coming down. Only a kshanam, but one kshanam for Shiva is how many years? That's what they say now. So, Shiva got angry, it seems. He said, though playfully you were doing this, it's not right. You have done something wrong. So, he said, for this, you have to go down and you have to do tapascharya. Then only you can attain me. So you have to go down. As if sort of he has cursed her, you have to go down. Parvati said, what? Playfully I just, you are my husband, I played with you. What is wrong? No. This is not the way to play. It's a serious thing. You have to go down and do tapasharya. Me doing tapasharya? I am your own. No, I am your own Shakti. What tapasharya I can do? No, you go and you will be guided. You go. So it is said, Parvati came down. And initially she came down to Varanasi, Kashi it seems. And there was drought, there was panjam. And people were really suffering. She became Annapurani there. And she was just giving food to everybody. And then she walked down it seems and she came to Kanchi. And there she was worshipping Shiva in the form of Linga in the sand, in the beach. Beach and she made a Shiva, she was worshipping. And there was a big wave, or a flood. She hugged Shiva, it seems. That is Ekambara Ishwara. There you see in that linga, even Ambikais, this bangle, that tadam. Tadam means what? That mark. And her mulai tadam. You can even see, now they say actually. And that is over. She got a sort of intuition saying that you go now down to Thiruvannamalai. There, Gautama Maharshi is waiting for you and he will guide you. That is the place for tapascharya. You have to go there. So even Ambihai was told to go to Thiruvannamalai to do tapas. It is said those days, Gautama Maharshi, he was residing at Pavadam Kundri, it seems. Even now the Pavadam Kundri is there. So his ashram was there, it seems. So Ambigai went in search of Gautama Maharshi. And Gautama Maharshi sort of welcomed her. And he guided Ambigai to do tapasharya there. And the sthalathoda rishi vandu Gautama Maharshi tha. Ile enna pudumai keta. திருச்சுழியோட ஸ்தலத்தோட ரிஷியும் கௌதம மகர்ஷி தான். திருவண்ணாமலையோட ஸ்தல ரிஷியும் கௌதம மகர்ஷி தான். பகவான் வாஸ் பார்ன் இன் திருச்சுழி அண்ட் கேம் டு திருவண்ணாமலை. தேர் இஸ் சம் கனெக்ஷன்ஸ். இட் இஸ் செட் ஆல்வேஸ். ஸோ அம்பிகை டிட் தபஷ்சர்யா தேர். அண்ட் தென் கார்த்திகை, த மந்த் ஆஃப் கார்த்திகா, கிருத்திகை நட்சத்திரம், தேட் டே ஈவினிங் பிரதோஷ காலம், ஷி வாஸ் அட்வைஸ் டு கோ அரவுண்ட் அருணாச்சல். So she went around, Ambigai herself did Giri Pradakshana. She went around Arunachala and then Lord was so pleased. He appeared and there he gave half of himself, the left portion of himself. And he became Ardhanarishwara. So this Ardhanarishwara avataram, it happened in Thiruvannamalai. So Lord herself went around the hill. And that day is Mahadeepam day. Kartikai Masam, Kritika Nakshatra. Evening, 6 o'clock, Mahadeepam. That is to denote the Shiva Shakti Aikyam. This is Ardhanarishwara Tattva. See, they say from the Pavadam Kundru, that is a small temple for Ardhanarishwara. The Ardhanarishwara come out. They give darshan. After that only, the Deepam is lit in the hill. They show a sign and then Deepam is lit in the hill. So, please understand, this is a very important sthalam. See, for Shiva devotees, which is very, very important among the festival, Shivaratri. Shivaratri, what is Shivaratri? This Lingodbhava, meaning this infinite column of light appearing, and the devas worshipped him. That is Shivaratri. Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, that day when the devotees worshipped, or the rishis, munis worshipped Arunachala, in that midnight, that is Shivaratri. So Shivaratri karanamum Arunachalamdam. And then Ardhanarishwarar, adu karanamum Thiruvannamalaidam. Even they say, this Devi Mahatmyam, the Mahishasura Mardhani killing this Asura, that also happened in Arunachala. That's what the Puranam says. Even for Navaratri also, Arunachala Kshetram is the Totruvai. Therefore, this Arunachala Kshetram is not an ordinary Kshetram. So, Bhagavan himself has said, so we have to go around Arunachala. And we have to worship him. We have to pray. We have to offer ourselves unto him. Adhumatra illa, anga vandu aarudhala ukkara palagam. Please, I am telling again and again. Come to Arunachala to sit quietly. And you need not do anything, he will do everything. That's what it is said now. He will do everything. You should allow him to do. See, when there is a surgery, doctor can do the surgery, but the patient should allow him to do the surgery now. The patient is not cooperating, how can the doctor perform surgery? So we have to come over there, just sit quiet. You need not come there and sit and meditate. I am going to meditate. No, not required there. You need to sit quiet. And he will work on you. And everything will be done. I am telling you, everything will be done there. And if you feel little lethargic or little this thing, you can go around the hill. You will be recharged. That is how we have to spend time in Arunachala. And what we have to pray to Arunachala. What we have to ask Arunachala. We are going to see two verses today. Beautiful, most beautiful verses. These two verses we will see. What to ask? That also Bhagavan has given. It's Padikam. Again and again I refer to Padikam because Padikam is the most wonderful thing. Out of all these five, Sudhi Panjagam, I say Padigam is the best, but there may be differences of opinion. Some people may say Arunachala Akshara Manamalai, but somehow I feel Padigam is the best. You know what Bhagavan says? We will chant. I will chant, you repeat after me. The ninth verse. Paramanimpadam
Paramanimpadam
Patrarapatrum
Patrarapatrum
Parari Ariyari Paraman
Parari Ariyari Paraman
Paramunakkenayan
Paramunakkenayan
Paniyarappaniyai
Paniyarappaniyai
Parithidum Unakedu Param Paramanirpirindu Ulahinai Thalayil Patriyan Petradu Podum Paramanamaruna Chalayanainiyun Adattinin rodukkurappare Paramanam Aruna Chala Yenai ini un padattinin rodukkurappare. O Lord Arunachala, ini now after means now un padattinin rodukkurappare. Meaning what? I should always be at your feet. And I should always hold on to your feet. Please never ever desert me or forsake me. This is the prayer. உன் பதத்தினின்று ஒதுக்குறப்பாரு, ஒதுக்கி வைக்கன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க இல்லையா, ஒதுக்குறப்பாரு. யூ கேன் டூ எனி திங் டு மீ, பட் ஐ எம் யுவர்ஸ், டோன்ட் ஃபோர்சேக் மீ. அண்ட் ஹி சேஸ் பரமா, பரம மீன்ஸ் பரமாத்மாவே, நின் பாதம் பற்றற பற்றும் பர அரி அரியரின் பரமன். யூ நோ வாட் சார்ட் ஆஃப் பர்சன் ஐ எம். நின் பாதம் பற்றற பற்றும், நின் பாதம் மீன்ஸ் யுவர் லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட், பற்றற பற்றும், we have to hold on to his lotus feet. Why? Then alone we can give up all the other attachments. Patrara patrum para ari ari ari, that is the real knowledge, how to hold on to his feet. So some people do not know how to hold on. Among them paraman, I am the chief, means in the world there are people who do not know how to hold on to the feet of the Lord. Why we should hold on to the feet of the Lord? Only by holding to at his feet we can give up all the other attachments. But there are a lot of people, foolish people in the world, who do not know how to hold on to his feet. Among them I am the chief, paraman. Means even though I want to hold on to your feet, but these vasanas are not allowing me. They are pushing me again and again outside only. I am unable to hold on to you in my heart. So there are so many people struggling without knowing how to hold on, how to focus attention to their own self. Among them, I am the chief, paraman. Muttalgalen adan mudalvan. So, param unakkena en paniyara paniyai. Now you have to take the burden. Yen pani arap pani ay. So that I need not do anything. Now you have to take my burden also. You cannot say, how can I take your burden? Because you are only taking everybody's burden. Parithinum unak edu param. How can you say it is a burden? Because you are holding the whole world on you. All the jivas are dependent on you, and you are only taking care of all the jivas. You are only guiding all the jivas. You are only carrying the world as if on your head. So how can you say it is burden? You have to carry me and my life and everything on your head. Parithidum unakkedu param. Parama, this is most beautiful. நீ பிரிந்து இவ்வுலகினை தலையில் பற்றி யான் பெற்றது போதும். Forgetting you, thinking I am the doer and I have to take care of everything, we have been carrying the world on our head like Hercules. Meaning what? I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to take care of my family. And if I don't, who will do? What will happen? Oh my God. We go on worrying, na? Meaning we forget that the Lord is a doer. And Lord takes care of everything. We forget that. And we think we are the doer. And we are doing everything. We have to take care of everything. அப்படி சுமந்து தலையில் பற்றி யான் பெற்றது போதும். Meaning what? We suffer and suffer because of this attitude. And still we don't give it up. He says, அப்படி நான் பட்ட பாடலாம் போதும் பா. பரம நீ பிரிந்து. பிரிந்து means what? As if I am other than you. Forgetting you, thinking I am other than you, the ego sense. And what it thinks? It has to take care of everything. அப்படி தலையில் பற்றி யான் பெற்றது போதும். Enough is enough, O Lord. Carrying this world on my head, I have suffered enough. Enough is enough. Now, please, I have only one prarthana. Don't ever forsake me. பதத்தினின் ஒதுக்குறப்பாரு. This is how we have to pray. How beautiful. So இந்த முட்டாள்களிலே நான் முதல்வன். உன்னுடைய திருவடிகளை பற்றி கொள்ள தெரியாத முட்டாள்களிலே நான் முதல்வன். அப்படி இருக்கும் பொழுது நீ தான் என்னுடைய பாரத்தையும் சுமக்க வேண்டும். ஆஹா, நான் ஏற்கனவே நிறைய பாரத்தை சுமந்துட்டு இருக்கேன், எப்படி உன் பாரத்தான் சுமக்கணும் அப்படின்னு சொல்ல முடியாது. ஏன் நீ தான் எல்லாவற்றையும் சுமந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறாய், ஆகவே இது ஒரு பெரிய விஷயமா உனக்கு, ஆகவே என்னுடைய பாரத்தை நீ தான் தலையில் சுமக்க வேண்டும், என்னுடைய பணி அறப்பணியாய். ஸோ தட் ஐ நீட் நாட் டூ எனி திங் பிகாஸ் ஐ டு நாட் நோ ஹவு டு ஹோல்ட் ஆன் டு யுவர் ஃபீட். தேட் ஆல்சோ யூ ஷுட் ஒன்லி டீச் மீ, ஆர் யூ ஷுட் ஒன்லி மேக் மீ யுவர் டிவோட்டி. ஸோ ஆல் தீஸ் டேஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஜீவ பாவனா ஈகோ சென்ஸ் ஐ ஹவ் பீன் கேரிங் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட் ஆன் மை ஹெட் அண்ட் ஐ ஹவ் சஃபர்ட் இனஃப் அண்ட் இனஃப் அண்ட் இனஃப். ஓ லார்ட் இனஃப், நவ் ப்ளீஸ் டு நாட் ஃபோர்சேக் மீ, கீப் மீ ஆல்வேஸ் அட் யுவர் ஃபீட் அண்ட் பிளெஸ் மீ, கைட் மீ, ப்ரொடெக்ட் மீ. திஸ் இஸ் அ பிரார்த்தனை. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவ் வி ஹவ் டு ப்ரே. பகவான் அதையும் சொல்லி கொடுத்துட்டார் எப்படி ப்ரே பண்ணணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு. சி இன் அ சாதகாஸ் லைஃப் ஐ டெல் யூ, ஹி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் எவ்ரி திங் கிளியர். ஹி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் அ கோல், திஸ் இஸ் அ பாத், திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி ஹவ் டு டூ. வாட் வி ஹவ் டு டூ, அகமுகப்படணும், வி ஹவ் டு டேர்ன் விதின். தட் இஸ் த பிக்கஸ்ட் சேலஞ்ச். வை? தோ ஹி நோஸ் எவ்ரி திங், சம்திங் விதின் வில் நெவர் அலவ் ஹிம் டு சிட் குவயட் அண்ட் டேர்ன் விதின். They are called as vasanas, negative sort of energy from within pushes you out again and again. Tirthayatra, mind says, I am ready with you, come, you will go. Tirula, I am ready, come. Vedanta Shravanam, very good, I am there. Professional satsangi, whoever comes, I am there first. I am ready. Study of scriptures, I am ready. Everything, I am ready. But sit quiet and inquire. அப்புறம் பார்த்து போமே. ஏப்ரல் 14 தமிழ் நியூ இயர் வருது, நியூ இயர்லேருந்து we will sit for தியானம், not today. So mind will postpone, saying that உட்காரவே விடாது. And he gives so many excuses, but all are excuses. தினயா மின்யௌ சாயம் பிராதஹ சிசிர வசந்தௌ புனராயாதஹ கால கிரீடதி கச்சதி ஆயு ததபி ந முஞ்சதி ஆஷாஷா. ஐ டெல் மை செல்ஃப் அகெயின் அண்ட் அகெயின் இஸ் பஜகோவிந்தம் வேர்ஸ். ஐ டெல் மை செல்ஃப் ஒன்லி, நாட் ஃபார் யூ ஐ எம் டாக்கிங், ஐ எம் டெல்லிங் மை செல்ஃப். தினயா மின்யௌ சாயம் பிராத்தஹ, மார்னிங் கம்ஸ் அண்ட் இட் டிபார்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் ஈவினிங் கம்ஸ். சிசிர வசந்தௌ புனராயாதஹ, த சம்மர் அண்ட் த வின்டர் கம்ஸ் அண்ட் கோஸ் அகெயின் அண்ட் அகெயின். கால கிரீடதி, டைம் ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ், கச்சதி ஆயு. Before realizing we have become old, middle-aged or old, my God, kala kridati gacchati, and we don't know our lot, how the health is going to be, how long we are going to live, we don't know. Tatapina munchati asha vayu. What is asha vayu? Vayu means what? Air. Asha vayu. This desire is like air, you cannot control it. Still it is not subsiding, meaning again and again, again and again. And the mind pushes us out again and again and again. Enna seyala? Koil kattalama? Aashrama kattalama? Adha cheyvoma? Idha cheyvoma? Ippa indha ulagathil ulla ellarku na gnanatha kodukka pore. The mind pushes you out again and again. Konja okkanda amaidhiya avara dhyanicha evlo arumaiya irukum. So that is why the prarthana is, oh Lord, I don't know how to hold on to your feet. Means what? Means abide in the heart. Adha meaning. I do not know how to always abide in the heart. This vasanadi is not allowing me to do that. It is pushing me out again and again. So among those fools, I am the chief. So now if you expect me to hold on to your feet, it is not going to happen. Now you should take that also as your responsibility. And somehow you should give me oda nalla kuduthu. Veliyulagathula pombora nalla oda kuduthu. You should make me to turn within. And hold on to your feet. That is your responsibility. It is not mine. Because I have failed. And I cannot. I know I cannot. That you only should help me. And you cannot say that it is all very difficult. Because you are carrying everybody's burden. So it is nothing for you. You should only help me. Hold on. And I am very tired. With this ahankara bhava, I was thinking I am the doer and I should carry everything on my head. என் குடும்பத்தை நான் தானே பார்த்துக்கணும், அதை நான் தானே பார்த்துக்கணும், இதை நான் தானே பார்த்துக்கணும், அது என் கடமை இல்லையா, இது என் கடமை இல்லையா, ஐ ஹவ் சஃபர்ட் அ லாட். இன் ஈஸ்வர சிருஷ்டி தெர் இஸ் நோ ப்ராப்ளம், இன் ஜீவ சிருஷ்டி தெர் இஸ் ஒன்லி ப்ராப்ளம். யூ மஸ்ட் ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட் பஞ்சதர்ஷி அண்ட் ஆல். இன் ஈஸ்வர சிருஷ்டி தெர் இஸ் நோ ப்ராப்ளம், இன் ஜீவ சிருஷ்டி தெர் இஸ் ஒன்லி ப்ராப்ளம். ஸோ பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஜீவ பாவனா ஆஃப் ஐ ஆம் த டூவர், ஐ ஆம் த என்ஜாயர், I have been carrying this for no reason and I have suffered enough. And now, O Lord, please do not forsake me. This is the prarthana. How beautiful it is. And to end with another prarthana, this is the most favorite. Annamalayai, repeat. அடியேனை ஆண்டன்றே ஆவியுடல் கொண்டாய் எனக்கோர் குறையுண்டோ, குறையும் குணமும் நீயல்லால் என்னேன் இவற்றை என்னுயிரே, எண்ணம் எதுவோ அது செய்வாய். கண்ணே உந்தன் கழலினையில் ஆதற் பெருக்கே தருவாயே, கண்ணே உந்தன் கழலினையில் காதல் பெருக்கே தருவாயே. அண்ணாமலையாய், ஓ அண்ணாமலையாரே, அடியேனை ஆட்கொண்டு அன்றே ஆவியுடல் கொண்டாய். சோ தட் டே வென் யூ சார்ட் ஆஃப் எம்பரேஸ்ட் மீ ஆர் டுக் மீ அவுட் ஆஃப் யுவர் கம்பேஷன் அண்ட் கிரேஸ், you have taken everything, my avi udal, this body and this soul, everything belongs to you, you have taken it. And somebody asked Bhagavan, why you didn't mention udal porul avi? Always they say udal porul avi, porul means wealth and all. Bhagavan very beautifully he said, porul irunda thani na eduthu kodukkum, porul means wealth. Konda enakkor kuraindo, can there be any kurai, sort of kurai in English, la
shortage,
short inadequacy, whatever, kurai na kadaiyadu, yen, because you have sort of taken everything and I have surrendered totally unto you. Appadi somebody comes and tells idu unude gunam, idu unude kurai, if somebody tells, then it is not mine, it is yours. Mm-hmm. Why? Because I have already given everything unto you, therefore if somebody points out as something as gunam or kurai, it is not mine, because my udal porul avi is yours. Mm-hmm. Everything belongs to you only. Ennen ivatra ennuire. So I will not confuse myself with am I doing good, I am doing the right, wrong, these, that, I am a good person or a bad person. See, this world will go on talking, good or bad, you know. If you go on thinking about it, you cannot live in peace. Because you have to say, God, my udal porul avi, everything kondai, niye kondu vittai, you have taken everything over. So everything belongs to you means what? Somebody when they comes and complain that you are bad, you are useless, you have done this, you are, it's also yours. If somebody comes and says, oh Swamiji, you are wonderful, who, it's yours. Ennen ivatra ennu ile, I will not think about all this nonsense. Ennam eduvo adu seivai. I am yours. Ennam eduvo adu seivai. This is the crux of the story. Ennam eduvo adu seivai. Eppadi irundhalum adha seiya pora nee. Oh, ennam eduvo adha seiya pora. Na solliya nee seiya pora. Ippa nama pasangalukku epdi solluvom illaya? Ennam eduvo adu seivai. Ye eppadi irundhalum sonna padi nee kekka pora nee. ஸோ எண்ணம் எது அப்படின்னா வி ஆர் அட் பீஸ் ரைட். அதே மாதிரி பகவான்கிட்ட என்ன சொல்கிறோம், எண்ணம் எதுவோ அது செய்யும். வாட் எவர் யூ வாண்ட் டு டூ, டூ இட். வை I am yours. This instrument is yours. So this flute is yours. Whatever song you want to play, just do it. Ennam meduvo adu seivai. But I have got only one request. Kanne, undan kalalinair. Kalalinaina, lotus feet. Kadal perukke tharuvaye. Let kadal peruk, let the love and devotion grow in my heart towards your lotus feet. Only that much I want. I don't want anything else. Not even mukti or bhukti. Why I don't want mukti? As long as we want mukti, we will not have mukti. That is the biggest obstacle. But if you have devotion for Lord, mukti will follow you. Why, Swamiji? I want mukti. I want mukti is the biggest problem. I is the problem. I want mukti is another problem. This I should go. So, even I want mukti is not the right approach. Yes, we have to strive, everything is fine. But to sort of become restless about you are no mukti kadikle, eppa kadikle, eppa kadikle. What eppa kadikle, eppa kadikle? Alla odadhaan kadikle. So the thing is, kanne undan kalalinair kadal perukku. When the devotion for the Lord, when it increases, what happens? The mind will naturally withdraw and it focuses itself. When that happens, that is the end of the story. Everything is gained. When you can focus your attention on the I or the self, then everything is done. And you need not do anything else up around. The things are done. And he pulls you from within. And then he keeps you there, rooted. So Adhan Sonar Arunachalanapati. Achalama Saidu Innuir Balihodum Igudyan. So now my mind is always extrovert. So if devotion for your lotus feet, if it increases, then the mind will not relish anything outside. It will turn within and it will hold on to your feet. That is it. And then I know you will do everything. See, this is a very important point. Whenever devotees visit Bhagwan, while they were leaving or taking leave of Bhagwan, they say, Bhagwan, enne marandra dinge abhin. Bhagwan used to say, நீ என்னை மறக்காட்டி நான் உன்னை மறக்க மாட்டேன். மீனிங் வாட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் வி ஹாவ் டு டேக். அகமுகப்படுறது நம்மளுடைய வேலை. ஏன்னு கேட்டால் அகமுகப்படாட்டி யாராலையுமே நமக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ண முடியாது. ஈவன் தட்சிணாமூர்த்தி இஃப் ஹி கம்ஸ் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் யூ ஹி கேனாட் ஹெல்ப் அஸ். வென் அவர் மைண்ட் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் இன் த வேர்ல்ட் எக்ஸ்ட்ரோ வேர்ல்ட், நோபடி கேன் ஹெல்ப் அஸ். ஸோ வி ஹாவ் டு புட் சம் எஃபர்ட் டு ஜஸ்ட் கோ, மீன்ஸ் டேர்ன் விதின், அண்ட் தென் ஹீ வில் டேக் கேர். அகமுகப்படுறது நம்மளுடைய வேலை. அதுதான் அவர் நினைக்கிறதுனா அதுதான் அருணாச்சலன் ஸ்மரணம்னா என்ன அர்த்தம்? அகமுகப்படுறது. அவன் நினைக்கிறது நம்மளுடைய வேலை. அப்புறம் அவனுடைய மற்றதெல்லாம் அவனுடைய வேலை. ஹீ வில் டேக் கேர் ஆஃப் எவ்ரிதிங். ஸோ கண்ணே உந்த கல்யாணம் காதல் பெருக்கு இது எண்ணம் எதுவோ அது செய்வோம்னு சொல்லிட்டோம்னு வச்சுக்கோங்களேன், எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் கான். ஆல் அவர் ஒரிஸ், ஆல் அவர் அஜிடேஷன், எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் கான். எண்ணம் எதுவோ அது செய்வார். Finished. That is surrender actually. Ennam yaduvo adu seivai. Whatever you want, you do. Oh Lord, I am yours. If somebody comes and says, you are wonderful, that is also yours. Somebody says, you are nasty, you are useless, that is also yours. Because everything is yours. I have already surrendered udal purul avi to yourself. Anda andre avi udal kondai. Therefore, everything is yours. Nothing is mine. Now, whatever you want to do, also you do. Anyway, you are the doer. I am not the doer. I have only one request. Kadar peruke tharuvai. Give more and more devotion. Who is saying? Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi is saying. Greatest jnani of our times. Who was always abiding in his heart. As if there is no emotion. That person saying, Kanne undan kalalinair kadal perukkedar. So therefore, devotion, when it comes in our heart, the mind naturally will withdraw and focus within. When that happens, there ends our effort. And then he will take over. And everything is done. So that is Arunachala and His glory, and I am so thrilled and glad to get an opportunity, another opportunity to think about Arunachala, to talk about Arunachala, to revel in Arunachala. So for that I thank you all so much. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Gacchate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Tomorrow we are going to take the life and teachings of Bhagwan, the sage of